Everyone wants to know what Facebook does or does not do about data. Suddenly, we see how the conveniences of digital technologies bring a heavy cost. Email, smartphones, e-commerce, Wi-Fi networks, social networks, these and other technologies form a massive surveillance network that tracks our every move, reporting on our daily activities to anyone who is willing to pay for our data. The Facebook scandal exposes the reality that the collection and trading of our personal data are being executed in the shadows. How much does Facebook know about you? How do they collect our personal data? How can we protect ourselves from their prying eyes? In this video, I will review some things that the industry doesn't want you to know. Facebook wants to know everything about you, starting with your very account. We all know that anything you do on Facebook is recorded and stockpiled. Even if you're locked out, data scientists have tools to match you to your username. Facebook also knows what you do outside of the Facebook universe. How is that possible? When you use Spotify, for example, do you sign in using Facebook? If you do, you are asking a Facebook server to verify your credentials. And of course, you just told Facebook you're on Spotify. We have all seen a Facebook like button. More than a means of self-expression, it is also a tracking device. When you visit a page on BuzzFeed, for example, the like button image comes from a Facebook server. Does that inform Facebook of your activity on BuzzFeed? When we use the internet or smartphone, we drop digital breadcrumbs everywhere. Sites like Facebook track you on Facebook properties and also when you're not on Facebook. When you see a Facebook like or share button on any website, or if you logged onto it using your Facebook, it means Facebook knows you're on that website. Many of us might not like to be followed everywhere we go. So can we protect ourselves from the prying eyes? Realize that our choice isn't between 100% protection and zero protection. We can sacrifice some convenience in exchange for more privacy. I'm running out of time, so let me leave you today with one quick advice. Don't use your Facebook to sign on to other websites. It's less convenient, but make a separate account. There are many more things that you can do to protect your online privacy. I will cover them in a future episode of Fung with Data. If you want to learn more about data, algorithms, and statistics, please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and spread the word. Comment your data questions and your online safety questions below. See you next time when we dive further into data. Principal Analytics Prep, prepping you for the data revolution.